Well, let's continue now. So now we coming to the most important discussion of today, that is the roadmap for implementing the IND AS. Which companies are required to follow IND AS? So it is like which companies are supposed to follow IND AS, we'll see that, and the remaining have to follow AS. Okay, so you can just, before we get into this, make one small chart about applicability of standards. Applicability of standards. I'm splitting that in two parts. The first one I have is for companies, and second one is for others. Others means other than companies, like individuals, partnership firms, LLPs, cooperative society, trust, etc. Applicability of AS. On GPFS. What is GPFS? General Purpose Financial Statements. Okay, we're talking about General Purpose FS. They have to follow these standards. Because sometimes you have to make special financial statements according to some requirement. That is not general, that is special purpose framework. So we're not talking of that. General Purpose, which is published and all, you can see that one. So companies. Companies are further split up in two parts, okay? Covered in roadmap of IND AS which rules will apply to them. Companies IND AS rules. And they will have to follow IND AS. So my entire syllabus is based on this. Okay. So obviously I should know for which companies it is applicable. That is in the roadmap, which we are going to see after this. And then other companies. Other companies have to follow the company's accounting standard rules. So they have to follow our accounting standards, the old accounting standards, but the notified ones. Notified means notified by MCA. Okay. Even IND AS are notified. All these are the MCA notified standards. We see, saw them on the website of MCA. Okay. And the others don't have any rules as such, because we cannot have rules for all of them. Okay. So they just simply follow the accounting standards issued by ICAI. The normal regular standards, which you have learned. Rather, you have also learned the AS old, the notified ones, okay? Because there also we mainly learn from companies' angles. So ideally speaking, now you can see we have got, actually speaking, four set of standards. How four set? One, the regular accounting standards issued by institute applicable for all the small, like individuals and all. Second, the accounting standards only old but notified by MCA for the companies to follow, 2006 rules. Third, IND AS issued by MCA for those roadmap companies. And fourth are the IFRS. Okay. So IFRS we don't apply. We apply these three. Okay. So this is how it goes. Fair enough. Then if you remember, for others, we had got that level 1, level 2, level 3 funda, which you had learnt in your intermediate. Forgotten. So we'll discuss that if time permits. Actually, it's not relevant for you all, but still, since you've forgotten, I would be telling you about it also. For these companies, we have got, see here, we have got three levels. Level 1, level 2, level 3. We divide our entities in three parts, level 1, level 2 and level 3. And according to them, we make the standards applicable. Not that everything applies to everyone. So that is as per my institute, L1, L2, L3 I call it. For my old accounting standard, notified standards, 2006, we had got two types of companies. Do you remember this at least? Bolo? Isme, AS old me, which ones? Companies, we had two types of companies. Sir, bhool jate. Right, CA final mein seedha. Jump to final. Non-SMC and SMC, remember? Small and medium sized companies and big companies. Listed and all, banking, insurance for big companies. I think we'll have to revise this also. We'll do it. Whenever time permits, we'll sit to an intermediate. We'll do foundation, you know? And then we'll do final when we get a little bit of time. It's okay. Even when I was a student, I used to not know all this. So it's okay. Chalta hai. Then, IND AS. IND AS is as per the roadmap that we have like all standards applicable. There's no like level 1, level 2 and all. Everything is applicable to everyone. In fact, IND AS is very strict here. You have to comply with all standards. You don't have a choice here. Okay. In our earlier 2006, we had got some relaxations to some companies like small, medium size. Don't follow this. Don't follow that. IND AS, nothing. Everything has to be followed. Okay, so no exemptions there. Here, I think some institute is behind. Because International Financial Reporting Standards and IFRS, we have set separate set of standards for SMEs, small and medium enterprises. They have that, but we don't have that. But good, we don't have that. Otherwise, you have to learn that also. So it's okay. But as of now, all IND AS have to be followed. So I hope this is clear now. Yeah. Now I come to the main topic. Which companies have to follow IND AS? So what they have done is they have made this applicable in phases. Okay. So you can see the phases are there. First thing we saw 2014 budget when our finance minister had announced it. So he had said from there only 1st April 15 onwards, any company wants to voluntarily follow it, they can follow them. So it was a voluntary application on which date? 1st April 15. But the moment you do voluntary, you're doing 2015, means I'm talking of the year 15-16. Huh? When I say 1st April 15, means I'm talking of which year? 2015-16. I have to present comparatives for that. Comparatives for that means what? If I'm presenting for the year 31st March 16 on that date, I also have to present 31st March 15. So by default, you have to also prepare for last year because you have to make that presentation. And there is one special point in my IND AS that whenever first time you're going to apply IND AS, whenever first time you have to apply IND AS, my law requires that I present, I'm giving an example now. My law requires I have to present on 31st March 17 plus comparatives you have to give for 31st March 16. This is the requirement. But my IND AS also, and even IFRS, and I won't keep repeating IFRS every time now, but the same thing it says. IND AS also requires that whenever you're presenting first time as per IND AS, you also have to present your opening statement. Opening statement means on 1/4/50. This extra you have to present. So you'll have three balance sheets only for the first time that you're going to make your IND AS. First time. So my March 17 is first, then I have to present three balance sheet columns. Okay. And then from next year onwards, it will be normal. Only two columns. This is the requirement of my standard because there are many adjustments which my IND AS say because first time you're following something and major changes you're following. So even opening figures will have to change and then opening reserves I have to adjust. All that I have to do in this 1/4/50. So now can you tell me if your first time comes on 31st March 19? For example, then what will you do? Which columns you will present in the balance sheet? 31st March 18 for comparative sake, that too you have to. Extra what you are doing? 1st April 17, opening. this is the extra thing you have to do. Got it? I hope this is clear. Okay, coming back. When you decide, any company can do this, okay? By the way, one thing I missed out is the thing which I've written in red there. This is for whom? This is for companies, but other than banks, NBFCs and insurance companies. They cannot follow voluntary. They have to follow as per the regulations. But any other company can follow it. But even company alone can't follow. So suppose I decide voluntary I want to follow. Then I'll say only I will follow. No, you too have to follow. Plus holding, subsidiary, associate, joint venture. Okay? I call it HAS-J. HAS-J, holding, associate, subsidiary, joint venture. All of them have to follow. So what companies will do, na? One thing they will do and their subsidiary is doing something else and it will become messy, na? So they say if you want to do, every time it has to be the whole group. Are you clear? Now, next. Achha, by the way, you will see rule I have written here. See in bracket. Rule 411. You know, that is that company, IND AS rules 2015. Okay. I think it's. Might as well I'll show you only now. Five rules are there, na? I told you. This my first rule, though, you know, name, short title and all that. Definitions, not to say, applicability of standards. That just tells me that, yes, these companies have to follow IND AS. That's what they say. And then, the main starts from this fourth one, which is about which companies have to follow it, on when you have to follow it. This whole thing comes over here. Did you get it? See, this is how it is. So, main rule is rule number four. What I'm trying to say is rule number four is the main thing. That's my point. Okay? Rule 1, 2, 3 is like time pass. Can't say on record time pass. Very important. Okay. So, coming back. So, I hope this is clear now. 1, 4, 15. Voluntary. Everybody but full group. Now comes 1, 4, 16. This is where actually things started coming in picture. 1, 4, 16 with comparatives for which companies? First, I have to catch hold of who? Listed. Correct? So, listed or in the process of listing. Even if you are in the process of listing, on 1, 4, 16, you are covered. In India, stock exchange or outside India, does not matter. Because remember, we are a part of that international organization. Doesn't matter wherever you are getting listed, you. But provided your net worth is 500 crores and above. Right? So we are not talking of, we are talking of net worth. Okay? So now if you will see, there are two points which come over here. Let me first complete, I'll explain. So 1st April 16, which companies have to follow? Listed or in the process of listing. Actually, if you'll see point number B, you'll understand even unlisted are covered. Basically, any of the companies which is having net worth of more than 500 crores and above. So A and B, if I see together, listed, process of listing or unlisted, having net worth 500 crores and above. And the moment I say these companies, what will come? HAS-J will also come. Point number C. Parent, subsidiary, associate and joint venture of above companies. Did you understand? So simply putting it, more than 500 crore net worth, whichever company, whatever company, you have to follow it. Okay. Now, two things have come here. Okay. Pay attention. Very, very important. Now, many students don't understand this. One is the listing 1 point. Second is the net worth 1 point. So when I talk about listing, listed or in the process of listing, I have to see that on 1st April 16 in this case. But when I talk about the net worth, I have to see that from 2014. Now you'll think, why 14? Because mera opening also have to present. Now don't forget. Plus from 14 only we had decided we wanted to follow. So if I would have announced only 14 directly, I would have said 16. Companies could have managed their net worth to let IND AS not be applicable to them. Hai na? Or just before the 1/4/16 they will say net worth has come down. Possible, na? So what they have done is, you will see, come down. For calculating net worth, see this point. For calculating net worth, following principles will apply. When will you see the net worth? Net worth shall be seen standalone FS, individual FS, not consolidated FS, on 31st March 14 or the first audited FS which ends after that date. Means it could be 31st March 15, it could be 31st March 16, right? Any. Not only 1/4/16 you have to see, what I'm trying to tell you. One student may think that, are applicable from 1/4/16. But if 31st March 14, my net worth was more than 500 and afterwards it came down. Still applicable. That is my point. So when you see net worth, you have to see which days? 31st March 14, 15 or 16. Any of the days. Any of that time. Okay. But when I say listed, my dear, listed or process of listing, this does not apply. For listing, what I have to see? Listing, which date I have to see? 1/4/16 only. So if I was listed earlier, then I got delisted. And in 2015, I am delisted. In 2015, I am delisted. Then 2016, I am not listed company. So you can't say, you were listed that time 2014-15. No. Listing applies only from that date. But net worth I have to see from 2014. Okay. Her question is that on 31st March 14 also you have to report on opening. 16 you have to opening you have to report. Yes.
So on first 4 it means that 31st March
13 the opening balance will be. No. On 1st April the opening which is there is going to be last day's closing, no?
That is 31st March 13.
Nahi na. Here. You're talking of this, right? This is the opening. You're saying in case of 31st March, 1st April 16, now we are starting with. So this is the first phase, people. Phase 1, understood? So if I see the opening also, it is going to be which date? 31st March 15 only, na? Year ending. It won't be 14. So I hope this is clear. So what did you understand? What did I say so far? Write this, or you get confused. In your notebooks, write down this. For listed or process of listing, this is phase 1 I'm talking about. Phase 2, I'll make another column. Means there'll be no confusion whatsoever. In phase 1, you have to see that on 1st April 16. In phase 2, it will be 1st April 17, next year. So, roadmap is there. So, 16 we introduced, 17, 18, 19, 20, we have got a roadmap of how companies will be covered under IND AS. So, listed or process of listing, check on date. But when I talk about net worth, when will net worth be seen? 31st March 14 or the years which fall, the audited FS which falls after that. So now my question for you, phase 2 is starting on 1st April 17, right? So for the first financial statements, 16, 17 year and 17, 18 year will be following IND AS. So their net worth I'll have to see on which dates? In the phase 2, net worth for which dates I will have to see? 31st March. 31st March, 14 will be there. Then 15 will be there. 16 will be there and 17 will also be there. Not feeling well, so just excuse me, okay? Now, net worth. Now see whether it's net worth or whether it is listed or processed. You are seeing it, net worth has to be seen on this particular day. So when I talk about net worth, what does net worth include? That is also important. Now what is included in net worth? So write down all these things. See, most of the things are there in the notes, but the way we present it is always easier to remember. So write down whatever you can, whatever I say, as much as you can. Some you write in your text, some you write in your notebook, but write everything. Okay. So net worth, when I talk about, it includes net worth, paid up capital for sure. Now the question will come, equity capital or preference capital? So what do you think the answer would be? Both will be coming, right? Yes, both will be coming, but you know, now preference capital, listen carefully. Preference capital or preference shares are what? Is it equity share, is it share capital or is it a liability? Preference shares. Liability, my dear. Earlier, what used to happen was preference shares we used to write under share capital. But now with my IND AS and all things which have come, now all redeemable preference shares are shown under liability. So here automatically what will come? Equity will come. Not I'm saying ki preference are not there. If it is irredeemable preference shares which are a capital, yes, it will come. But in our country, we're not allowed to issue irredeemable preference shares. So by default, it becomes equity capital. That's my point. So capital will be there. Obviously, I'm talking of net worth, though reserves will also be there. So paid up capital plus reserves. But which reserves? Free reserves. Like general reserve, P&L will be taken here. Okay. Specifically, they have also added securities premium. This is as per Companies Act definition. Securities premium. Though it is not a free reserve, but it is counted for this purpose. Then, capital reserve on receipt of government grant into bracket promoter's contribution. Have you learned this before? You have learned it, but do you remember it? Nobody knows, right? See, in AS 12, you have learned this concept that wherever government grant is received as promoter's contribution, I mean government is helping you in setting up your business, we take it to capital reserve. So that capital reserve here is actually nothing but the government is setting you, now. It is like your capital only. So that is counted. It is allowed to be taken. It should be taken. Okay. But I'm repeating, only that capital reserve, no other capital reserve. Okay. Then, what about ESOP? You know ESOP reserve, no? That is also, because it's a reserve only, no? So it is also counted. General reserve is there and all that. But then what is not there also, we should know. What is not there? What about DRR? CRR? Debenture redemption reserve? Capital redemption reserve? All this will be taken? No. Or konsa? Which one? Not all this don't be taking. Any other special reserve, revaluation reserve, all that not to take in your net worth. And for, I would say, you also write on preference share, so you won't be confused. Preference share capital, if liability, don't consider. If it is equity, you can consider it. PSC means preference share capital. If it is liability, don't consider it. This net worth is your section 257 of Companies Act. Same definition we have carried forward. I hope you understood. Yes or no? We do have a couple of questions even on this. I'll show it to you. But first let me complete my phase 1 and phase 2. Come back. Okay, so phase 1 we understood who is covered. Phase 2 now, we have in this phase, from 1st April 17 onwards, it's going to be there. Again, mandatory it is with comparatives and which companies? Let's see. All companies, whether listed, not listed, or in the process of listing, inside India, outside India, no matter, are not covered in phase 1 other than companies listed on SME. SME. Small, medium enterprise. We have a small exchange also. We are not counting them. Other than those, all listed companies. So basically all listed will come in this. Right? And then unlisted companies, second one, but having net worth of 250 to 500 crores. See? Unlisted companies having net worth greater than 250 crores, less than 500 crores. So in other words, 250 to 500 crores, if your net worth is, you're unlisted, you would be covered here. In from 1/4/17, all listed entities will come in. Net worth you don't have to see for listed. But for unlisted, it is going to be 250 to 500. That means less than 250 crores we are not taking over here. So the companies which are having net worth of less than 250 crore will follow what, my dear? Accounting standards. They will not follow. Are you asking now who will not follow? So these will follow, others will follow AS. I hope you're clear. Are you understand? Of less than 250 crores will follow accounting standards. 250 to 500 will follow from 1/4/17 and more than 500 will follow 1/4/16. I already followed long time back. I hope you're understanding what I'm saying. And of course what? Parent, subsidiary, associate, joint venture. Wo by default aa gaya. Now some small points. With small points, let us see. Companies listed on SME, not required to follow. Once Ind AS is applicable, every single financials have to be prepared as per Ind AS. All subsequent FS, you cannot reverse it. It is an irreversible decision. See, voluntary also some people will say, I voluntary followed. Now I don't want to follow now. Once you follow, you have to follow. So, isliye voluntary people are not opting for it. You got it? Mandatory though, don't have a choice. Have to. And those not covered by this roadmap will continue to apply existing AS, which is 2006 rules. Okay. For calculating net worth, what I told you, you have to see the principles as per rule 4.2. What is it? Net worth shall be calculated based on standalone FS March 14 or thereafter. But this will be for which companies who are covered in the beginning. But what companies which are not existing on 31st March 14? They were not there. Or an existing company which comes under this threshold afterwards. Means suppose in 2020 I crossed the net worth. Right now my net worth is say 200 crores and in 2020 it becomes 300 crores. Now what will happen? I am meeting the threshold now. For the first time I am meeting it. So now once I meet it in 2020, then obviously from 2021 I'll have to follow the standards. So then the net worth will be calculated when? Based on the first audited FS. And for that I've given you a simple example. See here. first, second, any example. I'm taking the second one. Companies meet the threshold on 31st March 18. So 31st March 18 means you did not come in phase 2. Phase 2 was 17, no? 17, 18 year. This is happening in 18 end. Got it, no? Then they shall follow standards from 1890. So 31st March 18, I know now, Baba, I have crossed the threshold. So next year onwards, 1819 onwards, 1418 onwards, you will start following standards. Okay? Yes, 31st March 18 is financial year 17-18. You're right. But that net worth I was seeing till which date? 31st March 17. You got it now? I had to make it applicable on 1-4-17. So I was seeing 31st March 17. Now I crossed it in 31st March 19-20. That's why I didn't take 18. Because it's difficult. 31st March 20 I crossed it. So from 2021, I will start following it. Okay, see the problem is why I'll tell you this confusion comes. Well, when you tell me this date, you say 1-4. And when you tell me net worth, you say 31st March. So you get confused there. But no issues. Okay, because 31st March is yesterday only now. So it's okay. Audited FS I want. Now 1-4 is not audited. So I need audited FS. That's why they take 31st March. That is the funda behind it. I hope you're clear now. Because slowly, steadily, most of the companies start growing, they will start coming under this. Now, you might be thinking, okay, only these covered. No, today this is covered. But tomorrow, so many companies will have net worth more than 250 crores. They will all come under this. And then again, question will come from when applicable. So, 31st March you became, 31st March 21 you became crossing. Next year you start. Next year you start, see what will happen further. 31st March 20, you cross the net worth. Huh? Listen carefully. So your 2021 you made as per Ind AS. Your net worth was, let's say, net worth is, let's say around 400 crores, for example. So 2021 you started following. Now what happened? On 31st March 21, your net worth, you made lots of losses and your net worth became 200 crores. Now what will happen? Once applicable, forever applicable, you still continue following. So once you come in the Ind AS net, it is like one no entry, one way. Once you come, you can't get out. Even once you come into it afterwards, no matter you become loss making, you become sick company, still you have to keep following. Question? If you don't follow standards, what will happen? Ye question. Okay. So what will happen if you don't follow standards? By not following standards, one, you're not following my Companies Act. Because Companies Act section makes it clear that accounting standards have to be followed. Section 129. Plus section 133 tells me that standards given by government, issued by government, all these standards are to be followed. And section 143 of my Companies Act puts duty on auditor. If standards not followed, you have to report, or adverse report you will get. So that is what it is. It is all to be followed. And if you don't, then auditor will report it. And plus Companies Act penalties will follow because you're not following the law. You know, these have legal backing, no, all these standards. Company accounting standard rules, not institute ka rules. So it has to be followed. Okay? Any other question? Sure. So let me go ahead now. I think phase 1, phase 2 both are clear. Yes or no? Did you understand the net worth to, for whom to see, how to see? Okay. So what I'll do is I'll do a couple of questions relating to this. Then I'll go further. What I normally do in FR is I take the concept, the sums relating to it. Concept, sums. Rather than only theory, and then only sums. Okay. You can see. Okay, now how are practical problems I have given you? Okay, I have given you type wise. And this applies to all the standards. It takes lot of time to get all the types together and do it properly. So it's systematically made for you. So these are the changes I've made from my previous notes. That's why I'm telling you this, okay? Like the first practical problems I have is on net worth basis. How to, what is taken in net worth, what is not taken and all. I told you before it's with answers, but does not mean each and every, now this is theory, I don't expect you to write everything. Huh? So you just mark it. But where sums are involved, we will solve it. Hmm? Achha, one more thing here. We'll be discussing it. The best thing is you also highlight with me. So next time you'll have to read the whole thing. So I'm just making it easier for you. Okay, so read the first question. Does the ESOP reserve, should it be included while calculating net worth? Yes, because it is a part of your reserves and it is to be taken. See, ESOP reserve, what happens eventually with the reserve? Either it becomes equity capital or it becomes a securities premium if you are issuing at a premium. And if they don't exercise the option, it goes into general reserve. Do you remember that? Huh? Thoda funda, right. So all that thing applies. Eventually it goes into reserves or equity. So it is a part of reserve. So you have to mention all that. Huh? You can't just write yes. Yes will get you half mark. And we have to get 5 marks in this question. Right? So come on. First though, what is net worth they have given? Net worth is as per 257. Subsection 57. What does net worth mean? It means the value of paid up share capital. See, the definition says paid up share capital. But I have applied my knowledge and understood that equity capital, not preference, because preference is not capital, it is liability, not share capital. I mean equity nahi hai, it is liability. And all reserves created out of profit means my free reserves. Securities premium specifically included. Oh, I missed out something. All this is to included, but what is to be minused? We have to write that also. Accumulated losses minus deferred expenses, miscellaneous expenses not written off, right? Now why I didn't write this? Did I forget it? No, the point is all this doesn't apply now. Deferred expenses we write off. Miscellaneous expenditure not written off is not there only. And even if I have losses, I have to show it as a negative balance in my P&L. So automatically reserves may it is considered. But by definition, it is to be minused. But by presentation, we don't anyway show it. We show it as negative, we minus and show it. So it does not matter. But because we want to go with the definition, we will write it in our that note. Huh? We'll write it. But first, let me finish the answer. Now, when they have given this answer, they have given as per guidance note on ESOP, which is what you have learnt in your advanced accounts intermediate, which we were just saying, you take it here, you take it general reserve and all that. But this is now covered in my IND AS 102. Does not matter, principles are the same. So it does not matter whether I'm writing guidance note on ESOP or I'm talking about IND AS 102. Principles are still the same. So here they say that the equity settled, whichever employee based plan is there, we show it in stock options outstanding account. And where does this option account eventually go? It goes to capital, securities, premium or general reserve. And same applies even there. In my IND AS 102, I call it SBP reserve. Share based payment reserve. But hai toh it's reserve only. So polo hai SBP. Either ways it's a reserve. Right? So all that will be there. And therefore it is to be included while calculating net worth. But they have also clarified that this is only for this purpose. I'm not saying net worth should always include it. No. For the purpose of IND AS and applicability, it should include. I'm not trying to say that everywhere and anywhere you do it, it should include it. No, it all depends on the situation. I think we should write down that also. That minus thing. Because we had started writing and then. Minus what all? Accumulated losses. Any deferred expenses which are not written off, or miscellaneous expenses not written off. But all that was old. Once my standards came, they told me write off all these things. So not very relevant in today's context. Okay? Then, problem number two, analyze. Yeah, yes it is. Now answer will remain the same, but you have to also explain that it is promoter's contribution as per accounting standard it is taken in capital reserve. Huh? Of course this treatment has changed with my IND AS, but all this was applicability we were talking about. Now when we are talking of applicability means they were following accounting standards that time, so these all things were there. So again same section 257. Rule 2, okay, that's fine. Capital reserve, promoter's contribution. In substance, this is nothing but capital contributed by promoters. So it is capital only, and net worth mein capital is taken. AS 12 also says that. And I'm repeating, this is only to be taken in net worth for the purpose of IND AS applicability. I'm not saying take it everywhere and anywhere. Clear? Problem number three. Oh. Analyze. Yes, applicable from year 17-18, sure? Okay, first thing, on what basis did you use this? How did you say it is applicable first? What basis you used? Phase 1 or phase 2? Phase 1. Why phase 1? Ek toh you are listed. First thing you are listed. Listed I see on 1, 4, 16 or 17. Huh? Depends on the phase 1 or phase 2. Net worth I have to see from March. Now you will see what happened. March 16, by the time they came, the net worth came down below 500. So they will say, no, it's not applicable. Answer is, it is because you have crossed it any time. March 14 or 15 or 16 we said. So you crossed it 14, you were there, matlab it is applicable. Now my question comes, from which date? From 16? Why 16? Okay, so on 31st March 16 they are listed, or rather 1/4/16 onwards. Now you are seeing phase 1, that means phase 1, let me see, on 31st March 1/4/16 they are listed, 1, and their net worth in the last 3 years any time has been more than 500 crores. So yes, it will be applicable not from 17-18 but from 16-17. Understood? It is simple, but once you understand the basic, then it is simple. Otherwise, you get confused here. Huh? Ah, boy got confused. Thoda confusion. Clear? Good. So again, rule 4. See, if you can't remember the clauses, just remember the rule 4. Okay, maximum times rule 4 only. Applicability full big rule 4 is only there. So as per rule 4, you can just say that, okay? Net worth shall be calculated on March 14 or 15 or 5, write down 31st March 15 or 31st March 16. Any of the days. On standalone basis, huh? And why they gave you this question? Because irrespective of the fact that later on the net worth has fallen down. See, even the net worth fell down, it was less than 500. what they try to confuse you with, ki it's less than 500, so it will come under 250 to 500, and you will think it will be phase 2. You will think it will be phase 2 because it is less than 500, more than 250. But no, it will be phase 1 only. So it will be phase 1, 2016-17. That is the way it is. They have also given one note here ki this point, 31st March 14, an entity was listed. But subsequently got delisted. Listen carefully. March 14 it was listed, but it got delisted, and in April 16, phase 1 time, they were not listed. Will this apply? No, it will not apply. Why? Because you are not listed. Listing point I have to see there. That's a different story. Listed, unlisted, all entities having net worth of more than 500 crores. That is different story. But I'm saying in terms of listing, you have to see that day. What I'm trying to tell you. See? Immediately before the mandatory applicable date, if the threshold criteria are not met, then it shall not be required to comply with standards. Of course, threshold criteria is not met, then I'm saying. Problem 4. Think and answer. Company A listed having negative net worth 600 crores. You are listed. A will be when? When will it be applicable in Ind-AS? Or will it not be applicable at all? Phase 1 may listed may it will be applicable? One by one let us go now. Phase 1 which companies come? Listed, process of listing, having net worth of more than 500. So this is not more than 500, no? My dear, negative net worth. You'll forget negative marks, negative. Negative net worth. So loss. So then in that case, not applicable in 16. 17, will it be applicable from 1/4/17? Who is coming under 1/4/17? Which companies? Listed and any listed and unlisted having net worth 250 to 500. Dhyan rakho, 250 to 500. So this won't come. It will because it is listed hai na. So listed hai, so this will come in phase 2. Phase 2 means when? 1/4/17. 17-18 will be the first year. What about company B? It is unlisted. Unlisted to phase 1 to out. Negative net worth again, it is. That's why I'm saying phase 1 out. Both phase not applicable because phase 2 also I can't take. It is unlisted. Net worth is also not is less than 250 crores. So phase not phase 1, no. Not applicable only for the time being. Maybe later on in 2020, 21, 22. Maybe that time it will happen. But now it's not. Now are you understanding? I think little bit of confusion is still there. So what I'll do is, again just tell me quickly what comes from 1/4/16. From your 16-17, which companies will come here? First listed or process of listing. POL means process of listing. With net worth of, yes. Secondly, unlisted also. Net worth more than 500 crores. So basically any company with net worth of more than 500 crores. And third? Has J. Of above. And from 17-18, this is phase 1, this is. Now phase 2, tell me. 17, 18 which companies? All listed or process of listing. Then I don't have to see net worth, all of them. What about unlisted? Net worth? Yes. Greater than 250, less than 500 crores. And again, all the group. Now are you clear? Sure. Negative net worth also we covered, huh, now. Problem 5. Analyze properly. Then we will summarize it. Think and answer, my dear. Whenever you're given so much of information, it's always better you make like how I'm making it. See what I'm doing. I'm trying to figure out what is the net worth. They're saying net worth above 250 but below 500 in 13, 14 and 14, 15. So these 2 years, I'm expecting the net worth to be between 250 to 500 crores. Right? But it is complying, okay, should it be complying under phase 2 given that net worth on 30, is expected to exceed 500 crore in financial year 15-16. So 15-16 expecting 500 crore plus. So asking should it be phase 2 or phase 1? Phase 1 clearly, why? 1-4-16 what I have to see? Your listed, unlisted actually in this case does not matter because you're exceeding net worth, and my net worth I have to see 500 crores when? March 14, March 15 or March 16. And March 16 you have exceeded it. So on 1-4-16 you are applicable. That means your 16-17 phase 1. Phase 1. So they're just trying to test you on that point that you are seeing net worth on any of the days, so it doesn't matter. Sixth. Take your time, analyze well. Not applicable? Sure. Support with your points. Which point are you picking up? It is a listed entity, right? Net worth is 50 crores. So ideally speaking, in this situation, I would have said, suppose some would have ended here. Then You would have said phase 2 because any listed, all listed will come in phase 2 because net worth is less, you know. You would have said that, but they got delisted on March 15. So on 16 also it's not listed, on 17 also it's not listed, and therefore it is not applicable, not required to apply because ceased to be listed company. Achha, tell me one thing. What if it got delisted on in March 17? Suppose it got delisted on March 17. My answer would still be same because you are less than, you are 50 crore. Means you're not phase 1. You would have come in phase 2. Phase 2 when I have to see? 1/4/17. You are not listed. Net worth is not in picture also. Right? Delisted and net worth is also less. So still not applicable. And suppose you would have got delisted on 15th of April. If you were delisted on 15th April, then applicable because 1st April 17 you were listed. Understood? So that point when, because see these questions are going to come up. And don't think it is 16-17 question. This question can come up in 2025 also. Why? Net worth will cross na sometime. That's why I'm saying that. Seventh. Your phase 1 net worth of 600 crores. Because your 600 crores means you have to be phase 1 only, no matter which company you are. Decides to give comparatives for 15-16 and 14-15. What would be your date of transition? So basically asking which is going to be the date you will start the financials as per IND AS. 14? Or 15. Let's go reverse order na. Reverse mein khel. We'll go according to reverse. Phase 1 means when applicable? 1st April 16. Right? So that means 1st April 16 your thing will start. So can I say your first balance sheet is going to be on 31st March 17? Correct na? Phase 1, 1/4/16/17 it is applicable. So 31st March 17 will be your first balance sheet. But you also have to present comparatives. Haan, to 31st March 16 you will press. This is compulsory. And what date bolo? Na 31st March nahi, 1st April 15. Opening I have to give. You know? I know technically it is different. That is closing, this is opening. 1/4/15. So can I say that their date of transition is April 15 or 14? 14. 15. Not 14, 15. Yeah. They are trying to say we want to give for 14, 15 also. Who told you to give for 14, 15? Correct or no? 14, 15. Na? Matlab they are saying last year also give. I am to saying 1/4/15, 15, 16 onwards. This is 15, 16. I am talking about, right? This is 15, 16. This is 16, 17. That's what I am saying. So date of transition is not 14, but it is 15. The first day that you are making it. Eighth question. So it's a section 8 company, associate it is, will the standards IND AS apply to them? Did we give any exemption to IND AS? No. We said your phase 1, you to have to follow only along with you. Your holding, subsidiary, associate and joint venture have to follow. Even if they are section 8, does not matter, it is applicable. So let us see what the answer they give here. Again, rule 4, that holding, subsidiary, joint venture, associate companies falling under any of the thresholds are required to comply with Ind AS. Your company and along with you, these 4. That companies under Section 8 are also complying with provisions of Companies Act until exemption is provided. As of now, they are not exempt from the provision. Not exempt from provision means what? Comply with Ind AS. No option. Comply with it. Okay. So, of transition, we are only doing the part 1 right now. Phase 1, phase 2 for companies. Problem 9. Problem 9. So basically, Ind AS is applicable to A Limited and they have a partnership firm, no? So partnership firm also has to follow Ind AS? That is the question. Dicey question. We said Ind AS is applicable to companies, right? We said it is applicable to holding, subsidiary, associate, joint ventures. But were we talking of partnership firms there? Which rules are these? Rules kaun se? Which are the rules? Companies Ind AS rules. Where did we go and see them? On MCA website. Now does a partnership firm or individual go to MCA website? Simple. So for partnership firms, individuals, normally AS apply. We saw in that diagram also, na? So there it will not apply. But then you will think, but this is going contradicting, na? There one time you said that holding subsidiary will have to follow. But I'm repeating, that was all for companies only. The rules only are for companies. So how can I say like this? So in this situation, partnership firms, individuals don't have to follow Ind AS. They have to follow regular accounting standards. But if, listen carefully, but if their company, their holding or subsidiary or whatever is a Ind AS company, then they will follow AS, but they will have to also make their financials as per Ind AS and give it to the holding company for consolidation. So you will make 2 set of standards. AS you will do for yourself. And Ind AS you will make not for yourself but for your holding to consolidate. That is the answer to this. Okay. So very interesting questions. I'm sure you're understanding now. Very interesting questions. All the questions which may come to your mind, which may not come to your mind, will be here. So remember, the applicability of Ind AS is specified for company classes. Classes of companies which are covered under roadmap. So Ind AS notified are applicable for corporates only. Then where will my poor non-corporates go? The non-corporates will have to follow normal accounting standard. We have also learned an intermediate foundation, something to we have learned that you follow there. They cannot be applied by non-corporate entities even voluntarily, because for voluntary purpose we had got companies only, na? Yes, some exceptions are there. Like point number 3 is exception now. See the exception. If regulator requires Ind AS, for example, SEBI has made it mandatory for Ind AS for infrastructure investment trust. Now you are a trust, so you are not a company. So, but still you will follow because SEBI has made it compulsory. Then you will follow. Real estate, investment trust, all this SEBI has made compulsory, so then you have to follow. Again, if CG also notifies anyone, right, then they will also have to follow. If notified, then follow, otherwise no. For other non-corporate entities, only Institute AS will be followed and no option to follow Ind AS. I hope this is clear. But so accordingly, in the given case, Ind AS doesn't apply to partnership firms. My answer gets over. But one more step I'm going ahead. What am I saying? Last point. For the purpose of consolidation, the firm will require to make FS as per Ind AS to give to A Limited provided it qualifies as a subsidiary or associate or joint venture of A Limited. So that way is I'm balancing out both the requirements. I'm not following, but indirectly I'm following to give it to them. So that is how it works. I hope this is clear. Is that enough for today? Quite a lot, right? So that's why I said applicability. I was expecting that we should be able to do it, but no, I don't think so. Maybe half lecture more I'll need for this. Because now the NBFC, banks, insurance, all that is pending. But whatever we have done, I hope everything is clear. So bottom line, what all we learned today? First thing, what we learned? So many things, right? First, we learned about the history. The first we discussed about our syllabus. Forget all history and all. What we have to do, correct? Four books are going to be there. Then we saw our paper pattern. Then we went for why IND AS? Why is this entire global scenario? What is there? What is Indian scenario here? Why are we doing all this? Why didn't we directly copy paste our IFRS? Why did we go for IND AS? All those reasons. What are carve outs? What are carve ins? What is considered to be carve out? What is not considered to be carve out? Correct? The difference is basically why they have come and what are they? Okay? Then we saw the list of standards. We didn't see the whole list, but we just saw that IAS, IFRS, something is there. Now it is called IND AS here. So all those things we discussed. And then finally, we started with the roadmap. In the roadmap, we just saw four companies, phase one and phase two. Okay? I hope that's clear now. That's all for the day. The next part, we'll be covering our banks, NBFCs, insurance companies, and for a group, how it is applicable. Right now, we're just talking a holding subsidiary. How does it apply? And all that we'll be checking out next. That's all for the day. Enjoy yourself.